Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time here, my name is Melissa Blevins and I share YouTube video marketing tips for your business to help grow your influence and your income online. So if that's something that interests you, hit the subscribe button and let's get into the video about YouTube Shorts. I want to share with you a quote that Gary Vaynerchuk has been saying for years, and that is document, don't create. He has said flat out, if you sit there overanalyzing everything and perfecting everything, working on that one piece of content once a week or once a month to try to make it so perfect, you're going to miss out on the potential of having a lot more viewers. So he says 6 to 7 times per day, you should be putting short form content out there. Hello. YouTube Shorts is perfect for that. So Gary V, he predicts stuff way before it happens, and he's absolutely right. You need to be doing this. So today's video is all about YouTube Shorts. If you haven't heard of this, you've likely heard of TikTok, and you know what a big sensation it is. Now, TikTok started as Musical.ly, which was this app that basically my kid introduced me to, and I thought it was always just going to be for kids to entertain and to sing and to dance and do these goofy hand movements. But it quickly grew into this massive, massive social media app. But YouTube Shorts is definitely a big time competitor of TikTok, and it is blowing up already, and it's just in beta. So what do you need to know about YouTube Shorts? YouTube Shorts are short clips, less than 60 seconds long, and they're just meant to grab a viewer's attention, and then they're gonna move on to the next one. The average attention span of a YouTube viewer is like a goldfish. I don't know if y'all have heard that, but it's a definite real thing. People hop onto videos, and if you don't grab their attention real quick, they bounce. But YouTube Shorts are a great way, especially for brand new creators, to come up with awesome, interesting content ideas without having to worry about all the fancy editing and all the special effects and things like that. So the things that you need to know about YouTube Shorts are, these shorts have to be vertical. Yes, you heard that right. YouTube is now saying vertical videos are okay. Now, I wonder when Pinterest is gonna say that horizontal video is okay on their platform, but that's another topic for another day. Vertical videos only for shorts, and they have to be 60 seconds or less. You also have to add the hashtag shorts either to your title or description, and a lot of creators are adding it to both just to be safe. So you're probably wondering several questions about shorts, and here's a Q&A for you. Where's the YouTube Shorts button? How can I upload a shorts? YouTube Shorts has rolled out a shorts camera in India, and they are about to launch it in the US and other parts of the world in March, so I hear. So right now, if you're sleeping on shorts and you're waiting for that button, you might be too late, because I think the minute that that camera becomes available, there's probably gonna be double the creators. And from the last statistic that I got from vidIQ was that there were over 600,000 YouTube creators that are utilizing shorts and using the hashtag shorts. So the next question, how can I create a short of my own? Okay, there are so many different ways that you can do this. You can use your smartphone and you can just record the short on your phone, and you can upload it directly to YouTube by just going to the YouTube app and hitting the plus button and create and upload the video there. If your video is going to be less than 30 seconds long, you can use IG Reels, create it in Instagram, and then save it to your phone and upload to YouTube directly that way. Another way, if you're really tech savvy and you've been a content creator and you want to go back, is you can repurpose some old content, or you can use like a DSLR camera to do it, but you're gonna need to change the formatting in your video editor to vertical format whenever you're editing the video. Make sure that it's vertical or it does not count as a short and all of your work is for nothing. But I don't want you guys to overthink this right now. You might be going, oh my gosh, that's a lot of information, that's overwhelming, I don't even want to think about this, this is a whole new thing. Trust me, you want to think about it, because short form content is where it's at. Like, people are moving forward, and the way to grow your subscriber base quickly is through YouTube Shorts. If you wanna see just how effective this can be, check out Jake Fellman's YouTube channel. I'll link him down in the description, but he has blown up from like 40,000 views to over 1 billion views on YouTube in just a few months using YouTube Shorts. So if you think that it's not relevant, you're wrong. So, so wrong. you got to do YouTube Shorts going forward. This is the part where I need to educate my own audience and say, guys, I'm so thankful for all of my subscribers. There's 5,800 strong in this group, in this community that I've grown, and I'm thankful for you. But you got to know that my goal is to grow bigger and bigger and bigger and to reach more people and to help more people with video marketing. That means that if I have to utilize YouTube Shorts in order to do that, that's exactly what I'm going to do. Get ready because I'm about to content bomb you, okay? Some key facts to remember about YouTube Shorts. Number one is quality isn't as much a factor as quantity. You need to be creating at least 2 to 3 YouTube Shorts every single day for the first week, maybe 2 weeks, and then you can bounce it back to 1 to 2 every single day on weeks 3 and 4. And from what I've heard through the YouTube creators community, week 3 to 4 is when you really start to see traction and growth. YouTube Shorts make almost no money. You might earn 2 to 5 cents per video, but the goal here is to grow your subscriber base and to have niche down content related to your main channel topic so that you can get people who have subscribed to your channel from your YouTube Shorts over to watch some of your long form content. And that's where your ad revenue will go up. Now, another question you might have, do I need to start a separate YouTube channel for Shorts? Mr. Beast did this. Some other creators have done this. It really depends on your audience. And if you already have a really good, strong, solid base of subscribers, and I mean tens of thousands of subscribers that you think you're going to piss off if you start uploading lots of YouTube Shorts, then maybe creating a second channel wouldn't be a bad idea. I was in a Clubhouse room the other day and one of the ladies said that she created a separate channel for hers and her main channel grew from 2,000 subscribers up to 20,000 subscribers as a result of her other YouTube Shorts channel. And she had them branded the same basically, but one was labeled Shorts. I personally am not going to do that, at least not for right now. You might see me correct myself later, but for right now, I'm sticking with the YouTube for business and video marketing topic and niche on this channel, and I can create YouTube Shorts right here that are related to that topic that are helpful to all lines of business. So that's what I'm going to do. But you got to do what I'm doing right now and educate your subscribers on the changes. If you're going to be uploading now every single day, the last thing you want is for people to be rude and negative and just trolling you because you're publishing new content every single day. Really what it comes down to is, are they publishing new content every day? Are they working their butts off to grow their own YouTube channels? I don't know what they could be mad about, but if they want to unsubscribe, they absolutely can. But you have to educate them on what you're going to be doing. What about audience retention? How is that going to be affected by these short clips? YouTube says that it's really not going to be a main factor. In fact, it could help you because if you have a bunch of YouTube Shorts that are a minute or less, and you have people that are actually watching 67, 80% of those YouTube Shorts in multiple numbers and lots of numbers, that can only help you. Now, if you create crappy Shorts and people are bouncing within a second, that could hurt you. But right now, while the getting is good, while it's not oversaturated, there's only 600,000 creators that are uploading hashtag Shorts videos, jump on it. Like, do not sleep on this. Do not waste your time. And like I said, you can go back and repurpose old content, cut it down. It doesn't have to be fancy. What about optimization? Do I need to optimize my YouTube Shorts? The answer is no, not really, because these are not going to show up in search results. These are going to show up hopefully on what's called the Shorts shelf. The Shorts shelf is on the homepage of YouTube. And it's if you scroll down just a little bit, you'll see short videos. And that is the Shorts shelf. And you want to ideally get your videos right there, but there's no way to determine whether or not YouTube is going to like your content and show it to more people. They've said that the more liked your content is in the beginning, the more traction it will pick up. But you might have a video that you uploaded and it got a few views and then it stayed steady and then it blows up and then it pops off and you don't have any more traffic from it. And the reason for that is it went on the short shelf and then it came off the short shelf. And they can always put it back on the short shelf at a later date if they decide to. But if something blows up like that, make sure that you're creating more content related to that and also longer form content related to that. Now, my challenge to you is to test out YouTube Shorts for 1 month. Just try it. Just see what happens. But when I say test it, I don't mean upload one video here and there randomly. I mean commit to it. 2 to 3 minimum shorts per day for 1 week, and then the next week, drop down to 1 to 2 shorts per day for that week, and then do 1 to 2, and then do maybe 1 short per week, weeks 3 and 4, and see what happens. The worst that can happen is that you gain subscribers little by little. And if you lose subscribers, they weren't meant to be there in the first place. Sorry, not sorry. One more thing I want to pop in here and say is that when it comes to optimization of my YouTube videos, I am all about SEO on my longer form content, or anything really. On every single video that I upload, I do keyword research. And if you want a copy of my free keyword search playbook, I'll link that down in the description below, or you can click the link up in my header. But listen, this is how you optimize a YouTube short. Drop 1 to 2 sentences in the description. Make sure that your title is catchy. It doesn't even have to be fully optimized at all. Don't do a bunch of keyword research. Just pop it out there. Make sure you add hashtag shorts to the title and to the description. And then add a few relevant tags, but don't overthink it. If you overthink this, you're not going to do it to the volume that you need to do in order to actually see the snowball effect of growth on your channel. So guys, who's with me? Who's going to test this with me? Let's do it the next 30 days and see what happens. Hit that subscribe button if you found this helpful, and I can't wait to hear about how your channel blows up in the next 30 days.